So, on the chat, someone came by and was wondering how to create a confined administrator that just needs to run a single script. But the script currently is not confined. So in this example, I'm going to try and show you that in a reasonable short time span. So I also need to probably demonstrate this on a Red Hat Enterprise Linux machine. So I just booted up my Red Hat Enterprise 6 machine, because there's basically a difference between the latest Fedora and Red Hat Enterprise Linux 6, a major difference between how it works in those two systems. So I just really need to do that on this system here. Let's see if I can. Yeah, so I'm logged in into my EL6 system, and I am a staff, so I am restricted. So basically what you have is, you have the script, which I'm just going to create. I need myself root, because I need to create that script. No. So now I'm root in the sysadmin domain, which is a restricted root domain. So basically what I'm going to do it now is, first I'm going to create that script, and just because that's what we need to do, confine a script. So I'm going to just create a script, a real simple script in user bin, sbin, because it's a privileged script. And I'll call it my script. And it's just bin bash, and I'm going to do just really simple simple script, like I said. So what I'm going to do is, I'm basically going to touch, or actually I'm going to echo something into a privileged directory. So for example, varlib, so touch hello, and then echo that in varlib, and then my script text file. So that basically, if the file doesn't exist, it creates it, and if it exists, it depends it. And that's basically simple. But if your script is complicated, basically largely the same stuff applies, but the policy will just be a bit more complicated. So you have the script here. Now I'll basically list that, and let's all see my script. User sbin, of course, user sbin. My script. So here it is. It's actually automatically created with the proper type, or at least the proper the type for generic binaries. So basically, if I do restore con rvf and then the user bin my script path, then it will at least reset the identity field of the file to the system U. And it doesn't make it's not necessary, but now it's basically as if it's installed by a package or something like that. So I need to make it executable. So gmod plus x, and then user bin my script, and then basically if I run it, my script, actually I can just do my script. And then ls alt varlib, and then grab my script. There is that file created, and it's created with a generic varlib type. Anyways, so this is basically what the script does. All it does is it creates that my script file. My script text, get that into a privileged directory, because normal users can't write to varlib. Because if you do lsdz varlib, then you'll see that it's root only for writes. So a normal user would not be able to write there. So let's just remove that file. We know that the script works the way like we want it to work. So rm, and we're back to normal. Now we need to basically create that policy. So there's two steps here. First, we're going to just create the script, confine the script, or at least on the one hand we're going to confine the script, and on the other hand we're going to confine the root at the admin, that is supposed to be able to basically run the script. So we have two policies. Now I'm going to make my project, or actually I'll just call it my script there. Make there my script, and then cd into my script, and then pwd, and you'll see that I just created a working there in the my script. So we're going to basically create two separate modules, because we want to basically separate the policy for the script and policy for the admin. So let's just start with touching some files, so just to make a distinction. So for the process, for the script itself, we're going to call the module my script, and we need a type enforcement file, and we need a type enforcement file, and we need a file context file. So let's touch that. And now as for the admin, we only need a type enforcement file, so we can basically just my script, and we call it my script admin. All right, let's see if there's something useful to say. Anyway, so back to our demo. So two modules, my script admin. So as for the my script, the script itself, let's start with that. So nano my script te, open it, declare a policy module, call that my script, and the version number is 1.0, and then just create two types, my script T, which is a process type. This will be the type of the process, and this, the my script exact T, will be the type of the script executable file. Now we can basically do it in a couple of ways. We can basically make it these two types make them usable in a single with a single interface, or we can do it the hard way by using the single interface. We make it more coarse than needed, so probably better to just probably best to just do it the proper way. Yeah, the way that's probably best. So first we'll make it domain type, we make the myscript _t type a domain type, so domain type, and actually this might actually not be needed, and we could look that also up, by the way. So if I save and exit, so I'm saving and exit this, and there's a dir here, lsalz user share as Linux devel, and then include, and I hope that it's installed. Yeah, it's installed, and then you have basically some stuff here. This is basically all you need to do your job. So for example, if I go to the system layer, which, and then you have a bunch of interface files here that basically are for the system, but we need to go to the kernel layer, by the way, because we need to basically look into the domain interface file, which is here in the kernel layer. So if I basically copy this over and then paste it in, and then less that, then I can see whether I need to basically use the domain type. So here's the domain base type interface API, and then here is the, oh, now I'm going all the way below, and this is the domain type API, and we're going to basically need a domain entry file API, and which is, let's have a look, domain entry file, domain use, am I overlooking it? I can basically do a search, domain I need to nano to search. So nano domain entry file. Here it is. And yeah, it actually we actually need to make it a domain type, so you get, and that's what I expected. So let's go back to our module. So you have a domain type, which is the MyScript _t, domain type MyScript t, and then basically you need the domain entry file, domain entry file, and I'll explain to you what that means. So you'll have the MyScript t as the first parameter. It expects two parameters, and the MyScript _ exec t type as the second parameter. And this basically tells as Linux the following. I can show you that actually. Domain entry file. So the domain type basically just classifies the type to be a domain type, a process type. That's basically what the domain type, the first interface call was. And the domain entry type expects two parameters, a domain, which is the first parameter, so in our case MyScript _ t, and a type, which is basically the executable file type, a type to be executed, of a file to be executed. Now, so basically this is what it allows. It allows the domain type MyScript _ t to be the basically it allows the MyScript _ exec t type to be an entry point to the MyScript _ t domain process type, and then it allows the domain type to actually read its own file type, and then it adds an attribute, an entry type attribute, and then it makes that second parameter, this the MyScript exec _t type a core command executable file. And you can basically look that up in the core command in the core command module here, what that means. So you can look all this stuff up in the user share as Linux Devel include, and then in the layers below there. You can look it all up. So anyways, back to the script. So now we basically created those types and we classified those two types. We told SE Linux, here are two types, and this is what those types are. The one is a process type and the other is an executable file type. So let's just take care of let's just take care of the interface file, so of the file context file, sorry. So we need to create a file context specification, user bin, my script, and it's a single file, and then gen context, and then it's basically system u object r, and then my script exec t, my script _ exec _ t. And that's basically tells us Linux, okay, that file, this path, the file in this path need to be labeled with this context. So now we have that set up. So now we have basically the basics for a starting point for the MyScript domain. So now we basically need to look at the MyScript admin domain. Now to set up an admin, there are also APIs you can use to make it really simple. So MyScript admin, we'll call this the module with this name. So this is the confined root role, so to speak, that actually is going to run that script. So what we need to do is we need to use this API, user DOM base user template, base user template, and this is basically a set of rules that sets up a base user domain, a very limited domain, and you could make it even more tailored to your requirements if you'd like, but then you'll need to you would need to write that in a raw way. Now basically we're going to design this so that basically we have a user that logs into the system as staff t _ t, which is basically a restricted login user domain, unprivileged, and then we're going to basically assign our new role, our privileged role, to that staff t user, so that that user basically can change to that privileged role and then run that script. So we need to actually allow the staff r role access to our new MyScript admin role, which is basically created by the user DOM base user template. This role is already declared there. So that's basically basically it. And then basically what we need to do is we need to basically tell SE Linux, okay, when this role runs this script, then run that script with a domain transition to a private environment for that script. So we're going to basically limit that script, and we're going to say to SE Linux, okay, when our admin runs that script, run that script in that limited environment. So how you do that? So there's basically a simple thing that you can use for that interface or pattern, DOM trans pattern, and then basically tell SE Linux, okay, when my script admin t runs a file with my script with type my script exact t, then transition from my script admin t to my script t. And that's basically, so now I'm basically allowing that admin to run that script, but not just run it that script, but also run that with a domain transition to a domain that is especially allowed to do what it needs to do, for example, write that file in varlib. So that's basically that, although there's some other thing, and I'll just add that here. So now we're basically not doing it 100% proper way, but at least a little bit proper. So now we need to basically allow the role access to the my script type. So role my script admin tr, and then types my script t. So now basically this should be basically it for at least for starters. So let's just make this make f user share SE Linux devel make file, and then it's actually everything in here. Now we have some issues here, let's fix them. My scripts, this is on, let's see, my script admin on line 2 is an error. So let's see, line 2 is an error, my script admin, oh yeah. So this is the issue, policy module. Let's see if that fixes it. And we have another issue, and this issue is on line 5, also on my script admin. So I'm making a little bit more messy. Syntax error, token. Oh yeah, we need to basically, since this staff role here is not declared in any of our modules, local modules, in this directory, we need to actually require it. So it's an external role, we need to import it, just like with Python. If you use some function, you import it. Now we use this staff role, so we need to import it. So gen require, and then basically just require the role staff role staff r, and that basically allows us to use it in our local module. So done that as well. Now we have another thing, we also need to require the my script admin role, and that's a thing particular my script admin. Yeah, that's, this is basically we need to basically just not just require it, but actually just declare it. For some stupid reason, this interface does not seem to declare it. Oh, actually, yeah. Yeah, no, that really seems to be, and this is also not right. This needs to be allow instead of, so this, probably this is just it. Instead of role stuff R, my script R, I was confused. This is right, but this was wrong, and this is basically allow the staff R role access to the my script admin. So let's save and exit that. But it still doesn't fix it because we have an unknown type. So we need to basically also require some other stuff, because that's basically the types that we're using here. The my script exec type and the my script underscore t type are declared in our my script module, so not in this local module. So if we want to use it in this local module, we need to basically first require it. So we're requiring a type my script exact t and my script t. because they're not local types, we need to borrow them from the MyScript module, which is in the same directory. Alright, so let's see where we get now. Now it basically builds both modules. Now, so let's just install them both. Sudo s, oh actually we don't need sudo, se module, and then I, and then MyScript pp, and also MyScript admin pp. But before I do that, I should probably see that I don't, well, I'm just doing it. See that I don't have already have a MyScript module installed. So now I basically set up the basics. But there's no policy yet. There's just some types that I declared. I mean, I created a simple base for a new user role. So there's no rules yet, except that I took care of the some of the transitions, not even all of them either. So it's a little bit messy, but we'll get through it. So now we basically need to set up that new user. So how are we going to go about that? So I'm going to basically create a new user. User add, and then that user is called MyScript admin. And then create a password, MyScript admin, and then that stupid password again. And try that again. See. And it actually worked. Alright, so we have this new user. Let's create a new SE Linux user. So SE manage, and then user, and then add that, and then a default sensitivity of S0, and then a range of S0, S0C, 0C1023. Just give it full access to any MCS ranges. I'm not sure if it actually needs that, but just do it anyways. So we have it. Basically a default login user role, which is basically staff R. So staff, when the user logs in, he's going to be staff. And then he needs access to that MyScript role, MyScript admin role. And that's basically all he needs. And then we need to give it a prefix of user, and then I'll call that MyScript admin U. And now it's loading into the system. Make creating that new mapping. And then that mapping will become available to us, and then we can use that mapping to basically create an association between MyScript admin underscore U and MyScript admin user, Linux user. This takes a little while, I'm not sure why it takes that long. So just be patient. So as you manage, login, this time login. A, and then S, and then MyScript admin U, and then the range of S0, S0, C0, point C1023, and then MyScript admin, that's what the user is called, I guess. And that basically creates an association between MyScript admin and MyScript admin underscore U, and gives that user full access to the MCS categories. Alright, so that's set up. Let's have a quick look at that. As you manage login L, and then you can see all the login mappings on the system. And then we have MyScript admin actually mapped to the SE Linux user MyScript admin. And if I look at the user mapping, then you can actually see that the MyScript admin user has access to default level of S0, the range, the full MCS range, and then it has access to two roles. So set up. Next, what we need to do is we need to basically also set up sudo, but we need to also set up default context, because we need to basically configure PAM, so that PAM knows, can tell the login program that the user should log in with the staff user role. Anyway, so that's CP, etc, SE Linux, targeted, contacts, users, and then staff U, and then basically copy that over to etc, SE Linux, targeted, contacts, users, and then make that my script admin. Make sure that the name is exactly the same as the SE Linux user you created. So that's CP that, and then basically we don't need to edit it. So we can basically just, this is just all we need to do, but I'll just get it to show you what's in there. So basically in this, there are a bunch of contacts here, and basically there's tell spam and the login programs that if, for example, if you log in via SSH, that you should, that the user should get this context. And yeah, we could basically just remove the other entries, and I'll do that just for the sake of simplicity. Nano, I remove the local login because this user isn't supposed to log in locally. Remote login because we don't use Telnet. We don't use cron, so I can remove that. We don't use SU, so we can remove that as well. We don't need initrc SU. We do need this one, and we don't need these two. So this should theoretically be suffice, and we can also remove this one here, I guess. So this basically we need to be able to run sudo, because we need to run sudo to go to the other role, to the my admin script admin role, and we need to basically need the first context because we're logging in via SSH. So we need to tell SSH, okay, when this login user runs in logs in, then give it that context. And this one is basically a default context for this user. So that's basically a basic. All right. So now we have that. We have it set up. So let's create a sudo log stuff. So ls etc sudoers d, and I already have a Joe. So let's have a look at Joe. Cat Joe. And it's basically all is all. But yeah, that's fine. So I'll just create another one. So nano. Or actually echo, I could just echo all this is my script admin, and then all is all, although I could basically make it more decent, and the type is my script admin t, and then the role is my script admin role, and then basically all, and then basically put that into etc sudoers d, and then a file called my script admin. Is that right? Let's double check before I hit enter. It's always a good idea to look at what you actually type. Seems right. And then basically we need to gmod this right properly. So that's gmod 0440, gmod 0440, and then just list it just to make sure that it's all same. And it seems all same. So we set that up. So now the user should be able to log in. So let's just try that out. So SSH, and then my script admin at 192.168.1.102, and then the port is like this, and then see if I can, and I need to enter that stupid password again. And I'm logged in. So let's look at my ID. So I'm logged in as staff with the MyScript admin underscore U identity. Now basically, now I should be able to run sudo. So let's try that. Sudo and then ID. See if that works. And I'll need to type the password in once again. And now you can see that I actually changed from star view from this context to the restricted login to the restricted root context. So now basically I am restricted MyScript admin. So now basically what I can do is, and I'm going to do that in permissive mode, because we haven't actually written policy for the script yet, so we're going to do that now. So set enforce 0 to just go into development mode, get enforce to test that, so we're in development mode, then go back to our thing here, and then I'm, instead of running sudo id, I'm going to run sudo my script. Was it that? Yeah, I guess it was that. So let's echo the exit status. We are in permissive mode, development mode. So it echoed right. So there should be a file created in varlib. And I'm not sure if I can actually, I can actually list that. Varlib grab my script. And the file is created. And you can actually see that it's created by me, because the identity of the file is my script admin. So the script ran. Let's go back to our system here, to our root, and see what OAuth says. OAuth MAVCTS recently. And then basically first less that, because there's probably going to be some AVC denials here. So it's actually not much, but it might not be all. But the script is very simple. What it does is basically, it does is create that MyScript file. And that's basically what it says here. Create that file, and then and add the name to the parent, to varlib, and then append to that file and open the file. And then here it also reads procmem info. That's basically the shell, because it's a shell script. So that's basically something, some bash issue. So let's just pipe this into audit to allow, and then R. And out to allow R will try to translate this into interfaces. So manage some of the stuff you can trust. But the main thing I wanted to show you, this one here, is what we need. So we can basically copy this over, this last one. This is basically allowing that user to read system. Actually, that's not, let's have a look. I'm making a stupid mistake here. You see, you know why? Because the no actual domain transition has occurred. And why is that? So let's just ls all z, and I know why that is. But you probably don't know it, but I know why it is. User bin, and then my script, and that's why also why there weren't so many rules, because this has been my script, because the script was actually not labeled yet. If you remember, in our cut my script fc file, we created this context, but we didn't actually apply it yet, so we need to actually apply that. Restore com rvf, and then the path. And now it will reset it to the. It should reset that. Oh, and I made also an error, so I'll fix that as well. There's an error. And hopefully you saw it, what the error is. It should be user admin, not user bin. It's a privileged script, so we need to basically also build it again. Make and install it again. Yeah, where are you? Here. And then in the meanwhile I'll go enter this a couple times in the hopes that I don't have to type my password again. So basically the file wasn't labeled yet, so the transition didn't occur. So yeah, sorry, a bit confusing for you probably, but also you'll learn a little bit about the things you need to be aware of. If you create a file context specification, then make sure that you, after you install the module, that you actually apply it, because else the file will have a generic type. Now I'll do a date. to get the system time. So we have 19:06, then go to this shell, or actually we'll remove the rm var lib and then the MyScript text file so that we have a clean slate. So remove that file, it's gone now. And now basically do the same again. Sudo MyScript. And now go back. And now also use OutSearch again to list the AFC denials, but only from 19:06 and later. 19:06. And see if the transition has not occurred. That's weird. Date. That's strange. My scripts. Oh, so why hasn't the transition occurred? So let's have a look. Let's go back at our module TE, and this all looks fine. And let's go back to our MyScript admin TE, and so there's actually this domain transition pattern. MyScript exactly, and then roles MyScript admin type MyScript TE. So why in the heck did the transition not happen? We can actually make that a little bit simpler though. Nano my script of sudo nano user has been my script, so that we can basically verify that. Just add an ID Z in there, and then go back and try run it again. See, it doesn't domain transition for some reason. What if I do the following? Sudo shell, and now run it. My script still not transitioning. User has been my script. Some weird behavior going on. Okay, still not transitioning. I'll stay in this root shell. LSRZ user has been my script. Double check that the file is actually. I thought I relabeled it. Oh right, that's stupid. I didn't apply it again. Now it's applied. Okay, so let's put the date again. Sorry for this, guys. This is really messy. So let's see if we're clean. I'll search M. Sorry about that. MAVCTS 1910 paste. And we're actually clean. So now we can basically try it again. So let's get out of this root shell, exit, and just run it again. And now you can actually see that the type done changed. So you see actually from MyScript admin, I went back to MyScript. So now I'm actually in the script domain. So now I have a proper view. And now you can see that there's also much more stuff going on. So let's out it to allow it. And without the R this time, just to see the raw rules. So this is basically the policy that we need, except this here. This is actually appending to bash history, I guess. Something like that. And we don't want to allow that. So we'll just copy over this stuff here. And actually, I need to do this all over. I'm going to do it all over, if not all over, but I'm going to first rm var lib and then my script text, remove that file, yep. And then I'm gonna also going to edit that script itself and remove the ID, because now I know that the domain transition happens. So now I can remove the ID because I know that it works. And then I'll search 1911 to make sure that I'm clean. and I'm clean. All right. So now let's try this again. And now have a look again. So basically now it's really only doing this for now at least. So let's just copy this in here in the policy module. So that's basically in the MyScript policy module, where is MyScript DE. Copy this in here and think about this. So basically what we're allowing here is we allow MyScript, the MyScript domain, to create a file in the varlibdir with the basic type of varlibd. But what we actually want to do is we want to create a new type for that file type, and then MyScript varlibd, and then also basically classify that type as a varlib type. So that's files type, or at least a files type, make it a type of a file, and then MyScript varlibd. And then basically tell as Linux that when the script runs that creates that file in the varlibdir, then create that with a type transition, file type transition from varlibd to MyScript varlibd. So that's basically done like this: file trans pattern, and then the source is MyScript T. This is the process type, and then in varlib t dirs, and then it's actually my script for libd. I think this is it. Been a little while since I used this interface. And then that's only for a file. So only this type transition happens only when the file is created. So, and then basically it needs to write to the parent, which is actually var libd. So for if you create a file, you do a couple things. You create the actual file, which happens here in the second line, but you also add a entry to the parent dir. So in the varlibdir, it needs to be able to add the name of the file and write the name right to it. So this rule actually stays, but this rule changes now. Basically, it's MyScript, because it actually needs to create the MyScript varlib type. And then it also needs to basically open and append, and maybe even more, but we'll leave it like this now. So this should take care of that. Save and exit. Go to the file context file, and also add a spec there, a file context specification. So varlib, and then MyScript, and then text, which is a single file. So we have this double dash, and then gen context, and then system view. Object R, and then it's my script varlibd S0, and then save and exit that and make and install that. Where are you, make? And we have a error here, unknown type script varlibd. Yeah, it's my script varlibd. And that seems to be it. Shit, unknown type varlib. Oh yeah, we need to actually require that varlib type, because it's not declared locally. So gen require type varlib. Try this again. Now it builds. Now install that. If I can find that sudo command somewhere in my history. Yeah. And in the meanwhile, hopefully I haven't okay, so I still don't have to type in the root password of the password of the user. So that's cool. So in the meanwhile it's loading still. And then we're basically going to remove that file again, and then just retest it again and see what else we need to be able to run this script properly. So rm varlib my script text, Remove that, and then I'll search MAVCTS1917, see if we're clean, if there's no AVC denials from old runs, and we're totally clean. So now we can run that script again, sudo my script, go back and see, and now we have new AVC now. So you need to really test it out a couple times, because it just doesn't show everything all the time. So we have here a get attribute, but you can see that the file is created with the right type, because else this rule wouldn't be there. So if I do ls alsi var lib my script text, then you can actually see that the type is now created with the my script var lib t type, with a special type for this file, because this is a sensitive file, so to speak. Now basically we are going to add this to our script policy. So open this, and actually what we can do is use either to allow R to see if it translated to something sensible for us. So this can't be translated. This is a good translation, this is a good translation, this is not a good translation. It's an MTA mail server user agent. I don't know where it got that from. And then read write inherit user so yeah, the only thing is that sudo it wasn't able to translate that properly, but all the others were translated properly. So let's just copy this over into our script and then paste it in and just edit it properly. So this one is wrong, and I'll just we'll just look at that again. And now it wants to also get attributes of the MyScript var lib file. So we can basically append a get attribute to this set of get attribute. And then basically you have the system, the kernel read system state, which is basically bash reading that proc mem info file. Then we have miss files read localization, which is basically files with locale underscore t, which are basically localization type files. And then we have the user DOM use inherited user PTIs. That's basically so that it can, if you run the script, so that it basically can echo back to the screen. So it basically can, if there's an error, then it could basically print an error message to your terminal. And that's basically saying that's good. So we took care of that, but we haven't taken care of this single one here. And maybe we don't actually need it. This, where is it? Blah, blah, blah. Here it is. So where basically my script needs to run a child terminated signal to sudo, and that's basically because we are running it in one single run, so to speak, sudo and then my script. But if we would instead basically first open a shell in the my script admin domain and then run the script from the shell, then we probably wouldn't need to send a child terminated signal. Anyways, let's just send an ID again so that I don't have to do the password again. So let's build this without that single, but without that one rule. There's one rule that I didn't add, that sudo sigchild terminated signal, this rule. I didn't add that for now, because I'd like to ignore that if possible. But if not possible, if it really needs it, then no problem. So almost done, guys. Hang in there, almost done. What I'm going to do now is actually go into enforcing mode. Get enforces permissive. So set enforce one, and I'll search to make sure that we're clean at 21, and we're clean, yup. And then ID, so we're still we're in stuff. I could just log out, actually then I need to type those passwords again, doesn't make sense. Anyway, so let's just run that script. Let's remove the file rm var lib, where are you? Here, so just remove the file. And now just basically run the script again, see if it works. And it doesn't actually work, see? Because it hangs. So something is failing here. Let's go see what that is. I'll search. And it's actually that one rule that we didn't add is actually messing it all up. And I can't even. So set a 4-0 real quick, see if it returns. Doesn't actually return. Damn. So it was hanging. PS out, grab my script. I'll just kill that. So we have a defunct here, as you can see. That's basically because it couldn't send a child terminated signal. That's basically because of that process here. So 18 kill. Minus 9, and now it's returned. Let's see if I can run a sudo id again. Yeah, so we really need to add that one rule, so let's add that anyways then. It's this rule here, so let's just add that. It sucks, but it so let's go back to our type enforcement file and I'll add this all the way below, and I'll just now there should be some interface that makes it more clean, but I'll just do it the nasty way. Gen require, we need to require that stuff sudo type. Type stuff sudo t. Okay. Make install and then finally remove the file again, and then it should work. So the stuff just basically failed because, and here is actually what's happening. So here basically we're logging in, which is SSH, which is stuff. Then we actually run this bash script as stuff. And then we actually ran sudo here, and then basically we ran the script in the MyScript domain properly. So let's try that PS out again, see if we're really clean. Yeah, we're really clean now. Remove that file again, rm var lib. Yes, and then set enforce 1 to make sure that we are enforcing, get enforce. So we're enforcing now, basically go back and now run that script again, and now it should work. Now it actually works. Echo exit status, and exit status is 0, so it did work. So that means that we should at 1925 should be clean with regard to ABC denials, and we're clean with regard, and that file should be created. LS var lib my script and then text. And the file is created. So now it's basically working. So this was just a simple script, but the idea is the same. First, you on the one hand, you confine the script, you create a separate sandbox for the script, and you create a separate sandbox for the restricted root, and then you allow the sandbox of the restricted root to run the script in the sandbox for the restricted script. So that's basically what is happening here. So I'll just cat TEFC, and this done. So you have a final look at the policy here. So this is basically all the policy that is involved, and this basically sets up this whole thing. Now, depending on how complex your script is, you're probably going to need more rules for your script, because my script is real simple. But overall, this is just basically all you need. So it's pretty darn simple, if you ask me. Get enforced, we're enforcing. Okay, and then get out of this shell here. Yep, we're out of there, and I close that shell. And then basically get out of here as well. I shouldn't have done that. Now I need to type the password. I need to basically shut that down. Shut down, halt now. Shut that system down. All right, so that's it.